In mathematics, we often solve for x, but what about y? Today, let's talk about why all of the angles in a triangle always add up to be 180 degrees. Let's start with a triangle, and it can be any triangle with any measurements for its angles, equilateral, isosceles, right, scalene, it does not matter. Since we want to show that this is true for all triangles, we are not going to specify what the angles of this specific triangle are, so you can go ahead and just draw any random triangle that you like. I'm going to place this triangle on our graph paper and rotate it so that one of its sides is horizontal. And I want to draw a line intersecting with the top point of the triangle that is parallel with our base. You can see here at the top that we have three angles. I'm going to label this one with a green line, this one inside of our triangle with a red line, and this final angle with a yellow line. If you recall, supplementary angles, or those that form a straight line, add up to be 180 degrees. So here we know that the green angle plus the red angle plus the yellow angle must equal 180 degrees. But if you also recall the idea of alternate interior angles, which if you would like a further explanation in a video on that, let me know. We know that this green angle and this bottom left angle of our triangle will have the same measure. Same thing on the other side using alternate interior angles. We know that the bottom right angle of our triangle has the same measurement as the yellow angle, so I can go ahead and label it as yellow. So what are the three angles inside of our triangle? Well, we have a green angle, a red angle, and a yellow angle. And we know that green plus red plus yellow equals 180, so all three angles inside of our triangle add up to be 180 degrees. So that's why all of the angles in a triangle always add up to be 180 degrees.